Last night was the Australian Survivor season finale, and Liz was crowned sole survivor, proving in the game to outwit, outlast and outplay, she wouldn't be outdone.
Here we are, endgame.
Nobody deserves that crown more than me.
If I don't win immunity, I'm out of here. I'm ready to get it done.
Two villains, two heroes, one last chance to claim immunity and get a free ride to the top three. The finalists given a dose of inspiration. As the season's most brutal challenge was unveiled.
I'm going to turn a crank, forcing spikes into your back.
Gripping to the medieval torture device, Liz secured her spot after a marathon 4 hours.
And that is it.
You are a superwoman.
Putting public frenemy number one, King George, in the firing line.
20th person voted out, George.
And that was the finishing touch on Liz's survivor resume, which she pitched with perfection to the jury.
If I'm going to take George down, this has to be the perfect moment. And you know when that moment was, George? That was last night.
Scoring the unanimous support of her former tribe mates and a cool $500,000 for her efforts.
Winner of Australian Survivor Heroes versus Villains, Liz.
All hail Queen Liz.
Bow down, because Liz is at the desk. How does it feel to be queen?
I'm so stunned. I cannot believe what has happened. I feel like it's just been a big blur of emotions and adrenaline, and I'm just ready to sleep and then wake up tomorrow and answer all my messages because I just haven't had a second to even think. I'm just so happy, so honoured, and I am just shocked.
Oh, it's such an incredible win too. Well done. This challenge that we just saw, this is actually a torture device. I don't know how we get away with doing this. You're a two-time Olympian, much discussed thing. Was it athlete brain that kicked in here?
Yeah, 100%. I went into another place. I think all of my experience being a professional athlete definitely helped me in that moment. But more so the fact that I knew that those three boys were never breaking up, and if I wanted a chance to pitch at the end, I had to win. So there was no way I was getting
down. Oh, so if you didn't win that, they were going to turf you.
Oh, 100%.
That
was
but did you know with your background, as soon as you saw the polls, you're like, I've got this, I'm going to outlast. Sure.
Well, more so the fact that, like, I guess I'm quite flexible being an athlete, and so that's why I kept telling Jonathan to crank it more, because I knew when I was at my limit, I could last longer than the other guys.
Right.
So I was, like, playing the game a bit.
Well, 47 days in the wild, what is the first big meal you eat when you leave?
Well, the thing that I ate when I left was I went straight to the hotel and I ordered one of everything off the room service menu.
Oh, standard.
Which came like 3 hours later at 4 a.m. and I had one spoon of each and just felt so sick.
You dethroned the king. There was obviously no hard feelings when you voted George out. Let's have a look at the moment it all happened.
Liz, I taught you to be ruthless and I taught you how to be a villain, and look what you did to me, and you're the only person to ever vote me out. I couldn't be more proud to vote for you, the worthy winner of Heroes versus Villains.
Oh,
he does have a heart. Oh, are you okay?
Yeah, I'm fine. Oh, it's so sweet. No, it's so sweet. As you can see, I cry a lot on the show, so yeah. I'm an emotional gal, but no, George is such a beautiful man and I've learned so much from him, and I know that we're going to be lifelong friends.
Oh, that's so nice. Speaking of nice, $500,000. Very exciting, huh? Let's talk fast cash. What are you going to do with the money?
I don't know. I'm, like, scared because I've never had that much money, so I'm like, what do I do with it?
Don't share it with George.
I would also not ask Sam.
No, come on, come over. We'll discuss some financial planning.
Some investing together.
Yeah.
I'll send you the money.
That sounds great. Lock that in. We saw that on camera.
Liz, you played such a great game. Congratulations again, and thanks so much for coming in.
Thank you.
Well done.